of us. I think there's someone with the mic on. You were trying to tell us something, bro. We can hear you. We can hear you, but you can't hear us, but we can hear you. So kindly fix your connection. So, in the meantime, can I have Mike? Mike, you can proceed.
Hi, good evening, everyone. I trust you can hear me, Cyprian.
Yes, I can.
So I think it's high time now. We've noticed what is going on. We've seen each and everything that is happening. And we have to act, and not just act by words, and act by action. And we are getting tired of this thing being a back and forth. Here, I'm saying this, you're saying that. I'm saying this, you're saying that. This time we need action, and this time we're going to act in a way they are not expecting. Tomorrow is a day. We are going to turn up. We are going to turn up and turn up in great numbers, and they'll not believe. For everyone and every soul that we've lost, may they rest in peace. And also, let's keep on the fight, and let's fight on. Avoid all this propaganda that is going on. We know that there are some people being used to say this and to counter whatever is happening. But we have to be strong to the movement and also keep on and be focused. Thank you. And all the best tomorrow. And have a great night, my people.
Thank you very much for where us from. Okay. We can proceed to the next speaker. Guys, I hope mnanisikia. So my next speaker, kindly proceed. Jay Paul, can we have Jay Paul? Jay Paul, kindly, if you can hear me.
Can somebody proceed first, then I take up next, because I'm finalizing something.
Okay, no worries.
Okay, so Cyprian, kidogo. So everyone, welcome on board on this space today. You know, many people, I'm sure, maybe you will find some people fear talking.
I don't hear anybody talking.
Or someone is talking, Rahit.
You seem to let me allow you to fix your connection first, then you can rejoin the space. Because we can hear you, but you can't hear us. Is that okay?
What is happening here? I don't hear anybody talking.
Fix your connection, Rahija. Everyone is hearing you. It's you who can't hear anyone. So I want to encourage, first of all, everyone on this space to be free. Talk out. And as we said before, in this space, everyone is going to be given the mic. It's not going to be something where like it's kind of monotonous for certain individuals. You are free to talk, and you are free to criticize whoever you want to criticize on this space. We can't tell people not to criticize us while we are criticizing anyone who is in power and wherever. We are free to be criticized. Feel free to criticize anything you want to criticize on this space. This is a free space. Feel free. So we can move maybe to our next speaker. Victor? Mike has already talked, right? So the guys who've already talked and they're okay, you can bring them down and you pull other speakers up.
I've brought up some new speakers, so they can kindly take them.
Phil, you can continue. You can speak.
Okay. I think you are getting me clear. So what I'm trying to say is that kesho wenye tunatokea, tutokee. Kama utokei usisumbwane na mtu, usianze kuforce mtu atokee. Kama utokei usianze kuambia mwingine sijui leo ni kifo nini, usitokee. No. We tokea ile namba yenye tutakuwa tuone kama tunaweza fanya huyo mzee atusikize. juu nimeona ameongea na Kiburu huko kwao jana. Nasema tuko faceless, formless. Mazee anatuite eti hatuna form. Hiyo ni kitu mbaya. So we have to pull up our socks. Tukue wengi mazee bana. Kama last week wenye tulitokea, mimi na tokeanga huku Kitengela. Na huwa tuna okay.
I think we've lost him on the space. Phil, you can speak.
Hello, ni aje? Unanisikia? Hello.
Bana, just go ahead. It's easy kama simu ya you.
Hey, kima jamaa ni aje? Bana, kesho tutoke kwa wingi. Si tunakuja na route ya mlolongo, kisha tutoke ama jamaa wanatufinya, lazima pia si tuwafinye ndio wajue sisi tuliwapigia kura hapo hivyo. Huyu jamaa, huyu Ruto huyu kwanza. Tunamuitanga Ruto. Huyu jamaa anaongea tu vibaya, ni kama hii Kenya ni yake. Tumuoneshe kesho hii Kenya ni yetu. Mnasikia majamaa? Hii Kenya ni yetu na sisi ndio tunawalipa na hizo taxes zetu. Wasikuwa naendesha ndege tunawapea hizo do, alafu si huku chini tunaumia. So kesho tutokee. Mimi majamaa wengi sana hapa hivyo wanalia sana, wana job. Mimi kwanza sina job, nacheki. Ama jamaa ametufinya sana. Mimi nimegraduate lakini sina job. Na hustle tu hapa Nairobi. Lakini kesho wenye utafika tufike kwa wingi. Ni hiyo majamaa.
Okay, thank you, Phil. J. Paul, you can proceed. J. Paul?
Yes, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes, are you ready now? So you kindly proceed.
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, sawa, sawa.
So natumai kila mtu ako poa, umeshinda poa. So, and I wanted to start from where Ruto left over the weekend, where he said that this is too formless. Jamana tuonyesha tu madarao. Na from the recent happenings, when imefanyika, mtu yote, hata kama wewe ni mjinga aje, unajua tu Ruto cannot get out of power by a ballot. Huu jamaa, tukimuacha, ati sasa tuseme ati give up saa hii, ama ata tufanye nini, you'll use the same tactics yenye ametushindia nayo, to rig 2027 election and even to change the constitution. Because sahi kwa hiyo parliament, hata ukiona mtu kama kina Karen Nyamu, kina sijui nani, hata Ruto akitaka kuchange constitution sahi, those people cannot kukata, hawezi kata. So the only options tuko nayo ni the streets. The only option tuko nayo ni the streets. So we are going to do this because for our future, we're going to do this for our kids. And for our parents and your watu walidanganya tukiwa dogo, and for our great grandparents. So I'm into this, na natumai kila mtu mwenye hapa ako pia into this, na tomorrow tutakutana street. Na mjue kuwa change in this country and mostly in African countries will never come through a ballot. Mwona change ya watu kama watu wa Burkina Faso, they are experiencing now, they have chased all these people wenye wanakuwa na mind mirror zao. Nini? Haikuwa through a ballot. It's not through a ballot. It was through military coup. Now people are saizi, they are seeing some positive changes. Sisi tukisema hita tunangoja ati through a ballot, at democracy, tunakuja tunaenda kuvota, we are going to vote out William Ruto. William Ruto rata sidani kama shai shinda nini free and fair. Yeah, ni kuhiba tu. That guy will rig us out. And he will use the same tactics enye metushinda nayo sai, atatumia hiyo 2027. Atajua, when I do this, nitashinda watu, regardless of what I need. So let us keep pushing on to press kabisa. Asanteni.
This guy by the name Deka. Deka, you can proceed. Your hand is up. You can talk.
Hi, Milton. Hi, Cyprian. Can you hear me?
go ahead.
Let me start by saying somebody here was talking about dialogue again. If majority of people have said there'll be no dialogue, shut up with that bullshit. Also, we have realized that it's a reality Ruto is trying to sell the country. Why are we here trying to say that there is a way of removing him by an election? That is impossible. The guy is a dictator and he wants to sell the country so that he can remain as a chief to Western forces. The reality is we are more than the people he's sending to kill us. So tomorrow, no one should let anyone be arrested. Those white trucks that carry people to go and get slaughtered, no one should enter them as you look. Do not watch anyone being arrested. You are thousands, they are small hundreds. No one should be arrested as you look. And also, another thing, as we march, let us ensure this is where we start the endless march. No one, if people have the spirit of going, of standing out at night, if people want to continue into the next day and the next day, let no one be a detractor telling people to go back home. This is the one opportunity we have of removing this demon. And we have to fight by all means. He's already deploying mercenaries. He was sending people from Uganda were here shooting people, and the Ugandan media identified them. Why will we stand and watch our people getting killed as we watch? No one should be arrested as we watch. That is my piece for today. Thank you.
Ambience, proceed.
Okay. Mi nachukua hii nafasi kushukuru kwa nafasi kuongelesha space. Mimi kuna mambo machache ambayo nimegundua kuhusu siasa ya Kenya. You know, someone like Raila, that man, I trusted him for so long. But what Raila has done, my trust in that man has just ended. That one I cannot lie. Mimi hata kura ikifanyika hii mwaka, mimi Raila siwezi mpigia kura kwa sababu hakuna vile wananchi wanaweza jitokeza, wanalalamika. And most of us are saying, we don't want dialogue, we want action. Ruto amesha jipanga, amesha panga kabile nini MPs, amesha wapanga, amesha panga vile serikali yake ataeka. Raila anatumika kuhijack ile mission yenye wa Kenya walikuwa wameanzisha na vijana most. Mimi kitu tu ningependa kuexpress kwa hii space. Ningependa kuambia wa Kenya, tujitokeze tuonyeshe Ruto hiyo wakati yenye wa Kenya walikuwa wanadanganywa na kuambiwa mambo ya uongo yenye alitumia wakati wa campaign imetosha. If he's not going to act, let Ruto face the action of the people. Kwa sababu we are tired. Kwa sababu, how comes jamaa ameona wananchi wamekufa, instead to control with us, analia about property. You know that thing people are saying many times, but this man is not getting it. Mimi tu ningependa tu kama wa Kenya tujitokeze kesho. Ruto aone wa Kenya kweli tumechoka. And if it get out of hand, itabidi wa Kenya wote tuuawe. Kama anataka aongoze nchi peke yake ni sawa. Lakini Ruto, enough is enough. Pia sisi tumesema. In case kuna wale watu wenye kwa space wanasikiza, pia waambie Ruto, pia sisi tumesema enough is enough. Kama ni mbaya ni mbaya. Nchi ni ya wa Kenya, nchi si ya Ruto. Juzi nimeona kuna hii nini yenye inaendelea ya minerals zenye wa Kenya wanajaribu kuongea, wanasema minerals zinachimbwa. This thing imekuwa tu silently. Hakuna kitu yenye imeongelewa, and yet wanasema Kenya iko na debt. Debt zitalipwa aje na kuna resources zenye government inaweza initiate pia watumie kulipa? You know Kenyans, we are tired. By the way, this thing yenye watu tunafanya tukienda kwa barabara sio ati tunafanya kwa ujinga. Ruto should know. Na kama ni mtu mwenye anajifunza, as a good leader you must learn. And Raila, hata watu wake kama wako hapa, nimeona watu kama Mbadi, hata Oguda, huyo jamaa nimemnyang'anya marks sana. Huyo jamaa pia ni mtu mwingine bure kabisa. Sifuna, we are learning things from people. Sifuna pia ni mtu mwingine mbaya sana. Sasa hivi leo Kenya wamegundua there are people who are after benefiting themselves. Sasa hivi wao wakiongea, Patielu wamekuwa kila dakika wakiongea kitu kimoja, wamecomment, wamejibu as our defenders. But sasa hivi leo tumeanza kuwa serious, tumeona ile mission yao hakuna, wamenyamaza. Mimi nimependa wale wanasiasa wenye wanasimamia wa Kenya na wanaongea about what Kenyans need. na hii space iendelee vitu, saidiane tufundishane. Hii Kenya ita change. Ruto akae akijua wa Kenya wameamka. Hata tuongoza vile anataka. Hivyo tu.
Thank you so much, Ambience. King Kai, your hand is up. Proceed. If he's not ready, maybe we can proceed to Kesh. Kesh, you can talk.
Good evening, guys. I hope kila mtu ako poa. I'm here to kuongea kuhusu the missing person, the missing people, actually. And napata a lot of DMs. A lot of people are missing kutoka 25th and the last protest ilikuwa tau CBD. So we have come up with an idea ya kuprint placards to be used tomorrow with the missing people faces, the missing person's faces, and the number to call in case wapatikane. Because we have tried to amplify this message on Twitter, and it's not working, but at least today, like, 5 people were found, luckily. So still, like, 13, 20 more are missing. We don't know where they are. Kenyatta ni kama it's a kidnapping, because a lady was abducted in Thika and she was found in Migori and wamekata from release. They just texted the mother and said she called the mother alipo sema apigia mamake akamwambia hi mom, I am okay, lakini usipige hii number and don't distribute my posters. So it's like kind of kidnapping, we don't know. So please, if you get any poster ya mtu yote yako missing and you can share it widely in Facebook, IG or anywhere, please kindly do share, because wazazi wanalia sana. People are missing for like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, someone is still missing. You don't know if the person is alive or not. Unajua heri mtu mwenye unajua kwenye yako, hata kama ako jela, you know, the person is in jail but not missing. So kindly, please. Tomorrow, I have one guy. I'll share his number. I'll share his handle for timeline. Tomorrow, he will distribute placards in the morning at CBD. You guys, when you march to JKIA, you can use the placards. So we want to get this missing persons. Thanks. And for tomorrow, please, kindly, tokeni mkiwa watu wengi. There is power in numbers. I've seen they have said the returning people telling them that it's a protected area, JKIA, but najua, it's not in the constitution. I know very well that. So you guys, tomorrow as you march in, and make sure you have someone, matching groups, matching numbers, to avoid these abductions. Isn't what you're talking, easy abductions. Mtu kukwanea akijaribu kushikwa, mnamvamia mwenye namshika. That's how we can be safe. Make sure you are with someone that you know, or anyone, just be in numbers. Yeah, mtuke kwa wingi, please. There is power in numbers. Don't let the police overpower you like last time. Otherwise, have a good evening, everyone. And please, if you have any missing person, still you can DM me. We make the posters and the placards. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kesh. On the topic you've just talked about, it is so sad that we are in a country where we are being killed by people who are supposed to lead us. I don't know how you want to lead people who you're killing. And I don't know what politicians usually feel or usually think of each and every time. Politicians think that we can all love them. It is impossible. And when they kill people, don't they think they will die? Let's give a chance to Danny to speak. The guys who have spoken, at least you can be dropped so that others come in. Hii si kama zile zingine watu wanakaa sana. Drop them and then others get it. Danny, you can speak.
Milton, kindly give me 3 minutes. You can give someone meanwhile. Please. I was doing something. I finish up.
Okay, Nakuru speaker. Nakuru. You can speak. The guy with the handle of Nakuru. Go ahead. I don't think he can hear us. Maybe he's having an issue with his network connection or the internet connection.
the guy with the name Antid, proceed.
Mnanisikia?
Go ahead.
Mimi nilikuwa nataka kusemaje, venye jana Ruto aliongea nyasi jana. So kuna unajua yeye alienda huko ushago alienda kuanga na watu ushago huko. Wenye watu hata hawana stima, unajua chenye kinaendelea kwa ground. So si ndio tuko kwa ground. Mimi naishi hapa karibu na Syokimau, so from penye niko mimi wana tu ndege ikilanda. So anytime kukaa kuna wa mlolongo hivyo, tukitokea si wote na wakitengela alafu na wa town tupatane, ni hivyo. Msetu lazima akuwe kwa ground. Lazima tumwangushe ndio atusikize. Hakuna vile anaenda huko ushago, si akuja ongelea upuzi yenye alikuwa anaongelea juzi huko. Story na ushaga tutaki akuja town. Kwa sababu tunajua kitu inaendelea kwa ground. Nivo.
Thank you so much. Guys, you are allowed to rant. Say whatever you want to say. Yeah, this is a free space. Here we hata ukuwe na 2 followers utaongea. Hapa si ma verified account peke. There's a lady by the name Sharon. Proceed. If she can't hear, Ontuga, you seem to be having a very burning issue. Proceed and then you get dropped down.
Okay, guys, can you hear me?
Proceed.
Okay, thanks for this opportunity. Mi kwanza kitu ningependa kusisitiza. If you see those tweets, those tweets where people are posting people who have been missing, please kindly repost them. Dr. Saidiana, kuna wao watu wenye wamepotea, watu wapatikani, wametafutwa na their kins na wapatikani. Secondly, venye there's a guy walikuwa anasema venye Ruto jana alikuwa huko mashinani. You know, alienda kutumia watu huko mashinani threaten us because watu huko mashinani don't have a lot of information that we have. So that's why you saw even the population that turned out was big. Na ilikuwa na sherehe, ilikuwa na chant Kenya, yeye anataka kusikia. Na probably hawa watu hata walilipwa. So guys, Kenya Ruto wanatry kufanya saa hii, acha isimamishe wa movement. If I quote John F. Kennedy vile alisema, those who make peaceful revolution impossible will make violent revolution inevitable. Please guys, kesho tutokee. Isikuwe ni atisiati tunaambia napa online. And then kesho tupate tuko wachache. You know what will make us defeat them is our numbers. Because we don't have weapons. Our weapon ni phone. Na maybe our flag. Please guys, make sure tomorrow you turn up. Numbers is what will help us achieve what we want. Thank you.
Thank you so much. There is always power in numbers. And when you don't have the numbers and you lose focus, you're going nowhere. That is it. That is something that is very important. Numbers, numbers, numbers. Dennis, you can speak.
Sawa, sawa. Okay, niko hapa. Mimi ni Dennis kutoka Kisumu and first and foremost nataka kusema big up kwa kujitokeza na kuonyesha bravery. Ya pili nataka ku comment hii decision ya kupick JKIA kama stage yetu kesho. Yeah, you see when you took a town walikuwa wanaongea alafu wana take advantage for the fact that tume surroundiwa na businesses, so wana hire goons na ina interfere na our peaceful demonstration. Huko JKIA hawana hiyo advantage, sisi ndio tuko na advantage juu kuna international eyes, yeah, wanatuona and waweze leta hiyo jenga plus waweze tuma mapolisi wakafikiria JKA. I think naambia big up, alafu kesho tujitokeze, yeah, kwa wenye wezi kufika. I think wa show support huku social media, you see, na wenye wako na different opinion, I think it's better to keep quiet support juu division ndio power yao, lakini tukiwa united sisi ndio tuko na hiyo power. So let us that power, let us be united and front this enemy na to make sure tume win. Ni hiyo tu kwa sasa.
Thank you so much, my brother. Vincent, you can talk. I don't think we can hear him. So, Kenya, there's a guy with a handle of Kenya. You can proceed.
Yes, yes. Good evening, all wonderful Kenyans. I just have a simple submission to make tonight. First of all, thank you for the progress you've made ever since the revolution began. For the majority of the courageous Kenyans who fought on the front line.
I think you are having a network.
You're enjoying a few.
Kenya, I think you're having a network problem. Fix it so that at least people can hear you when you're talking. In the meantime, Moses can
just confirm if you can.
Well, yeah, hello.
Your system is having a lot of echo, so we can't hear you well.
Okay,
so
okay,
fix it. Hello?
Moses, can I speak now?
Yeah, Moses, speak.
Okay, thank you for this space and I appreciate for hosting us. But I had a lot of issues to talk about with this government and how they are running their political ways. These people were highlighting that our guys are going back to the villages, trying to incite the villages against those people who are living in the urban areas. Now, politicians use those scores. Example, now, they want to garner numbers in the villages which they think will interfere with the information we have. Now, but they are forgetting that people who have more information, like informed, well, who are ready to go and make revolution and change, are people who are living in urban centers. Now, because we are the people, we have come out from our villages because we are no longer living on the neocolonial areas, or maybe we are using stone hotel. Now, they are trying to go back there, inciting the villagers against people who are living in urban centers. If they succeed doing that, with the same back and forth, going back to the villagers and then siding against people who are trying to put revolution in town, maybe they will throw us out of the game. Now, that is why we are supposed to mobilize any urban settler who feel maybe amefinywa na serikali. Hapana ingie katika games ya serikali ya kukimbia village huko kuinside baguga huko nyumbani alafu tunarudi hapa. So that has to mean we should also be talking to our parents if their parents are back at home, that these people are implementing laws which are selling our country. Now, because they said political is a game of contact, it has now we go to the ground. Like tomorrow I'll be in town. I'm not be able to reach the KIF. I don't know about that, but I'll mobilize even if my three guys in Kwaplot tusonge na wao, and I know everything will be all right tukisonga hivyo. So we stop the politicians from driving some narratives, now bringing the villagers, bringing the wasis. Now they are bringing the old even the speakers to speak in the like media houses. They are bringing the old MPs. Now they had time to do something. What the best can they do now? They don't have anything to do. Now let us go fight for our rights and I'm sure we'll survive. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Kokon, you can speak.
Thank you for the opportunity. Nilikuwa nataka niongele four issues hapa. Kesho tukienda kuoccupy JKIA, nini, our revolution lies in our numbers. Kesho tukikuja watu wengi, ndo tutakuwa able to achieve kitu tunataka. Alafu nimeona a letter from the IG anasema ati JKIA is a protected area. Polisi walikuwa wapi JKIA kikuwa list to Adani Corporation? Like saini anaona ati it's as a protected area, ati anasema ati watu wasiende huko. What the fuck you IG, fuck Ruto, like mnatubeba aje bana, sisi watoto. Na parliament pia nimeona on a recession kesho, like kesho wakijaribu kufanya hiyo maneno wanafanya, tunataka JKIA tukipitia hapo. Wamesema ati ni 90 million wame lose this time, wana lose more than like the old parliament. Alafu nimeona gava inasema the main source of revenue ni tax. Atukatai, yes, ni tax which is not accounted for. Na nimeona kuna a lot of minerals hapa Kenya. Mbona hii minerals inakuwa kama personal nini ya our MPs? Kesho tutokee majamaa, tunaoccupy hiyo kitu, wase wangu wa Kware pipeline, Mlolongo, tutokee. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Nyadi, I see the handle is Nyadi something. Nyadimo, speak.
Okay, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity. Guys, so far we have so many voices of reasons from different platforms, which is very good. And the truth, guys, is we must be deliberate. The opportunity we have now should be properly and accurately executed, because we might never have another opportunity. As we speak, we have managed to disrupt the political system. We can see both the government and the opposition, it's shaking, which is very good. That was our first strategy, which has worked very well. Second, is tomorrow we are aiming to disrupt, we are doing the economic disruption.